caviar. It's considered the most expensive food in the world and can cost up to $4,500 a pound. For the last 200 years, it's been a luxury item, gracing the plates of royalty and dignitaries. Traditionally, caviar was a staple of Russia and the Middle East, harvested from the wild sturgeon populations of the Caspian Sea. But today, the world's largest and best producers of caviar come from China. I went to China to visit Kaluga Queen, now the world's largest caviar company. It turns out 70% of China's caviar and 30% of the world's supply.
Taste experts generally say that Chinese caviar is the most superior caviar on the market now, certainly the most superior farmed caviar. And that's because it has a sort of very fresh, salty taste, which is the closest taste in taste to wild caviar. The operational capacity of the Chinese caviar supply chain is far superior. Chinese caviar, it can be fresh all year round, so it can be harvested and brought to market and sold and consumed within 4 weeks.
But how did China, a country that traditionally doesn't eat caviar, come to dominate the market?
The reason why, basically, is because they got really lucky. The food trade in general is really influenced by political events.
Here's the history. Wild sturgeon was abundant in the Caspian Sea, but the caviar industry was heavily regulated by the Soviet Union. When the Soviet Union collapsed, the industry became a free-for-all, leading to corruption and illegal fishing. Caviar numbers dropped. The illegal market became 10 times larger than the legal one. And because of corruption, the Convention for International Trade in Endangered Species banned the export of Caspian Sea caviar.
Since sanctions were imposed against importing Russian products in 2015, people are just not importing it anymore. The market has shifted towards Chinese caviar, not necessarily because of perception, but because of market conditions. The people who invested into those farms 10 or 15 or 20 years ago just got really lucky.
Today, a majority of the world's caviar comes from farms like this one.
I'm Wang Xianche. 现在我们所处的位置，浙江杭州千岛湖，我们站的这个网箱基地，是我们卡罗加鱼子酱的一个相当于一个资源库，它一个后备青鱼的一个培养的一个地方。The
sturgeon is an ancient fish species dating back to the Triassic period and has an average lifespan of 60 years. But these don't get to live that long. It takes about a decade for them to reach maturity before they are slaughtered for their eggs. First, they begin their lives in a nursery.
一般这个鱼苗孵化之后，这个尺寸达到30厘米到40厘米之后，我们会运到千岛湖去。这个鱼它喜欢好的水，因为好水养好鱼嘛。The
fish are raised in the lake for 7 to 15 years, depending on the species. Then, in their final moments, they're transferred here.
在我们加工之前，我们会对这个鱼子酱进行一个静水时间。 然后保证它体内的一些饲料啊，还有杂质啊，消化掉。Then
it's off to the slaughterhouse, where the caviar is extracted and canned in a matter of minutes.
然后养九年，你会不会对这个鱼有没有什么感觉？像你肯定也是有感觉的啦。我们不是经常开玩笑的，大家在一起开会什么的，因为我们这个鱼是养完以后，我还。
再给我另外一个基地，因为我们都是要加工厂的那个，就我们同事，我们叫他屠夫，因为他是把我们辛辛苦养了七八年、十几年的鱼全部给杀掉了嘛。当然，这些我们也有另外的一个双向的一个理解。卡鲁瓜昆总共有大概300多个员工，这300个员工背后大概代表300个家庭，这些鲟鱼鱼子酱。 也相当于在照顾我们这300个家庭，我们要在这个10度的环境，在15分钟之内完成16个不同的加工步骤，然后快速的完成这个步骤，来保证这个鱼子酱的品质，保证它没有这种微生物细菌的滋生。这些鱼子酱加工的最重要的一个步骤就是拌盐。 拌盐貌似很简单，可是这个需要大师有多年的经验，他就要根据鱼的不同的品种，鱼卵的弹性的大小。 然后进行这个种力道的不同的掌握，然后它让它把这个盐跟卵进行充分的吸收，才能把鱼子酱的风味最大的发挥出来。
这个主要就是六个品种，达什黄，欧洲黄，然后俄罗斯杂交狮豉，西伯利亚。
Now the beluga caviar is the most expensive.
这 beluga 大概在60,000一公斤左右。
They can live for up to 100 years, but in the wild, the species is one of the most endangered. To this day, it is illegal to import beluga caviar into the United States, even farmed ones.
西伯的价格在8000人民币一公斤左右。当初我们考虑这个品牌的时候，卡鲁嘎 Queen， 因为卡鲁嘎这个鱼它只有在中国有，在阿穆尔河里，然后令这个鱼而且会个体长得很大，而且它的鱼子酱的品质也非常优秀，很多厨师比较喜欢这个 Hybrid， 因为 Hybrid 的它这个弹性很强壮，然后比较 firm 那种感觉，然后厨师会做一些菜系的造型啊，它甚至可以在手上一颗一颗滚来滚去都不破裂这种感觉。
Today, Kaluga Queen is the caviar of choice for many suppliers in high-end restaurants around the world.
然后一年可以养殖多少？你的 capacity 是多少？
目前2017年的话，我们加工出口了大概67吨鱼子酱。
In 2018, China shipped more caviar to the U.S. than the rest of the world combined. But a tariff increase amid an ongoing trade war could mean a slowdown in business.
Inching closer to a trade war, Donald Trump threatens new tariffs on $200 billion worth of Chinese goods.
Trump 的税肯定是有影响，可是我们的品质现在已经被大多数的美国消费者所接受。可是这个量的增长就会放缓，因为这个税对我们、对进口商、对他们的消费者会无形的增加这个成本。
But not every country is ready to publicly admit that they serve caviar made in China.
In Paris, the majority of Michelin-starred restaurants in Paris use Chinese caviar on their menus, and they state the origin.Of the caviar on the menus, whereas in London, the majority of high-end restaurants in London don't actually state the origin of the caviar. So when people hear the word caviar, they automatically think of Persia and of Russia, and that's the customer expectation. And when they hear that the caviar is not made in one of those places, they wonder whether it's inferior. There's a perception gap there between what people are used to and what they've always had with caviar, which is the wild sturgeon caviar. And farmed caviar is probably going to replace a lot of the...wild caviar on the market because it's just the stocks just aren't there for wild caviar anymore.
While not everyone is convinced, aquaculture companies like Kaluga Queen say they are providing an environmental benefit by farming the fish instead.
就是我们不想让外界误认为就是Kaluga Queen好像像一个 monster 一样，一个巨人一样，然后大肆的杀鱼啊，做这个。我们只是想，一是通过我们这种养殖模式。来减少这个对野生捕捞的压力。鱼子酱很多年前是俄罗斯跟伊朗的传统加工产品，然后起初卡鲁嘎 Queen 成立的时候，我们是也是向很多伊朗大师、俄罗斯加工大师，然后学习跟了解怎么加工鱼子酱。可是过去的这么多年，我们也自己消化这些知识的同时，改进了一些细节问题，然后有我们自己的一些想法、自己的一些技术进去。然后这么多年过去，然后现在甚至有一些伊朗啊，或者是俄罗斯的加工大师来中国，跟我们探讨怎么加工更好品质的鱼子酱。就是有的时候，学生也会变成老师。